Welcome to the Knox video training series. In this video, we'll show you how to log in and navigate the Samsung Enterprise Technical Support customer portal. We will also demonstrate how to create a new support case following best practices. Let's get started. In order to access the customer portal, go to ets.support.samsung.com. For the best user experience, we recommend using the Google Chrome browser. Enter your email address and the password that was sent to you through email and click Login. You'll then be redirected to the welcome page. In time, this page will be populated with more useful information customized based on how you use this tool. Let's move to the My Cases tab. In this tab, you'll see all the cases you and other named callers raise. By default, the Recently Viewed Cases filter is applied to this list. To change the filter, click on the drop-down icon next to Recently Viewed Cases. There are three different list views available: Closed Cases, Open Cases, and Recently Viewed. Select the Open Cases view to see all the outstanding cases you or other named callers have raised for your company. If you want to make this the default view, click on the pin icon next to the drop-down arrow. Let's move to the My Devices tab. In this tab, you will see your assets. An asset is a group of devices that you own. There are two different views available: My Assets and Recently Viewed. Select the My Assets view to see all the assets created for your company. Later, we'll upload your devices to an asset. Next, the Training tab. By clicking on the Training tab, you will be redirected to the Samsung Business Academy. In the Academy, you will find various product trainings in the form of e-learning. Let's move to the FAQ tab. In this tab, you'll find some frequently asked questions regarding the customer portal. Over the course of time, this list might change. Now that we've toured the customer portal, let's upload devices. In the My Devices tab, switch to the My Assets view, and then click on an asset. When the asset opens, click Asset Device Management. You can add devices into the asset individually or through a bulk upload. Because ETS customers have thousands of devices, we recommend using the bulk upload option. Click on the bulk upload button in the top right corner. Click Download Form to download the CSV template. Then, use a text editor to fill it in with your device's details, including their IMEIs or serial numbers. When you're done, click on the Upload Files button and select your CSV file. The devices you uploaded are added to the list. Click Save. At any time, you can modify the device list as needed. Now, let's raise a case. In the My Cases tab, click New. Fill in the details of the issue. It'll be easier for us to perform a root cause analysis of your issue if you provide accurate and detailed information at this stage. In step one, choose the product type. Select your country. Select the issue's severity level. And set the date you expect to receive a diagnosis. In step two, set the sub-request type to tech issue. Moving on to product details, provide the model code, the OS version, the IMEI or serial number, the CSC version, the number of affected devices, and how often the issue occurs. In step three, enter the issue's subject and describe the issue in detail. If you have log files, pictures, screenshots, or movie files, add them by clicking Upload Files. Each file can be up to 2 GB in size. Click Finish. In the next screen, all the details you provided are displayed along with a new case number. At any time, you can view your open cases in the My Cases tab. An ETS engineer will review your case and provide their first response based on the available data, so the quality of the details you provide in your case is important. We would like to share with you some best practices that can help us analyze the root cause of your issue. Describe the issue as accurately as possible. The issue's description is the first field our engineers will analyze, so it helps if it has a lot of useful details. Specify the type and number of affected devices. you see the problem on a single model or on various devices? Was it reported by one or more countries? Knowing this information will allow us to better understand the issue and its impact. Provide the OS version. Did this issue appear after an OS update, or is it manifesting on devices running different OS versions? You can find the binary version details by dialing the code *#1234# on your device's keypad. Dump state logs are also very useful. For most issues, these logs help our engineers determine the cause of an unexpected behavior. You can use the Issue Tracker Lite application to easily extract the logs. Finally, tell us how to reproduce the issue. This will help speed up the root cause analysis. This concludes our video on how to use the Enterprise Technical Support Customer Portal. For more information on other Knox solutions or services, visit docs.samsungknox.com. Thanks for watching. Thank you.